We got to keep God first. We got to stay humble. We got to keep working, and we got to get this money. Economic empowerment is what's going to keep all of us on the straight now.
Yeah.
Everybody.
Like Jesus.
And so as I'm live on the show, I actually reach out to Pastor Sonny. I say, hey, you guys mind coming on the show next week? And he was like, yes. And I was like, perfect, yes. So we're going to be talking about marriage and money today, guys. So like I said, tell a friend to tell a friend. Give us a call. We're taking all of your calls about money, about marriage. 855-75-MONEY. That is 855-75-MONEY. Also, guys, hashtag money making motivation. So hit us up on Twitter. Twitter at E.DeanCole. Hashtag money making motivation. If you can't get through, if you're sneaking and listening at work, which a lot of you guys do, tweet me. I will read your questions live on the air. On Facebook, hashtag money making motivation. On Instagram, hashtag money making motivation. We're everywhere you want to be. We have more coming after this. This is Money Making Motivation, your number one source for economic empowerment, right here on SSN ATL. Hot off the money presses, guys. What's going on in pop culture? What's going on in the news and how it affects you? Ladies and gentlemen, I have some sad news to let you guys know. If you did not know, if you did not hear, unfortunately, the legendary Charlie Murphy has passed away. And he passed away abruptly from leukemia. Did you guys hear about Charlie Murphy passing away? Did you hear, did you hear about
that? Yeah, from leukemia. It's real sad.
It's real very, very sad. And it touched me. I have some clips that I got to play with you guys, but I have to preface and say this. I have been blessed to have three brothers. And when I was listening to D.L. Hughley talk about Charlie Murphy, and then I was reading Eddie Murphy's tweet, I got very emotional because I have three brothers, and we're not as close as I wish we were, and it did something to me because I'm a cancer survivor. Like, wow. I beat cancer. One of my brothers was in total denial of it, and he was like, no, you don't have it. But then my oldest brother, who I thank God, he actually nursed me back to health. So I actually left Atlanta, went to North Carolina, and he helped me go through the entire process of beating cancer. So this whole situation, it made me feel some type of way. And so I thank Jehovah God, if it was not for my brothers, if it was not for what I've gone through, ain't no telling what would happen. So the thing about it with Charlie Murphy is that he was filming on Power, and nobody knew that he was sick. Same thing with me. Nobody really knew that I was sick. Mm-hmm. And come to find out, in my treatment, they asked me if I wanted to have my thyroid removed, if I wanted a thyroidectomy, or if I wanted chemotherapy. And I said, y'all going to have to pull this thing out of me. Listen, I'm not going to pump that poison in my body. Now, glory be to God. You know, he is the balm in Gilead. A lot of people are healed through chemotherapy. That's them, and that's their story. But for me, I just decided to go through the whole surgical route. So that being said, so that just happened, you know, in the news. It doesn't necessarily, does not necessarily benefit your finances or whatnot. But at the same time, I just wanted to share that because that's just very, you know, very riveting and whatnot. So we actually have some audio of, now, D.L. Hughley, I love D.L. Hughley. He's very conscious. He's very woke. He's very unapologetic. He stands 10 toes down in the African-American community. I really do like D.L. Hughley. And he cried like a baby when Bernie Mac passed away. And True to form, he started to cry again on national radio yesterday talking about his good friend Charlie Murphy. Listen to this.
After every gig, we would all go to his room just to watch him tell a story. I can't pretend like I didn't know he was sick, but I thought that the way he handled himself and the way he laughed, that he would be all right. Charlie Murphy had such an indomitable will that you believe what he told you rather than what your eyes told you. But I am sad that he's gone, but I'm also happy that I got a chance to know him. I think that he was a great comic and a man's man. And I think that when we first started on the Comedy Get Down tour, well, the bet we used to make was who would go to jail first, either Eddie Griffin or Charlie Murphy. I can say that as sad as I am, I can tell you this about Charlie Murphy. He was the best storyteller I've ever heard. He rushed home to be with his family after every gig. He did comedy his way, and he died with gigs on the books.
All right, so right after that, he begins to break down crying on the air and whatnot. It becomes very emotional. So, yeah, so that was D.L. Hughley, one of his close friends, talking about it because it was very shocking because he didn't tell many people other than just his close friends and family. Have you guys ever gone through anything
similar? I haven't gone through anything similar, but I've known people that battle cancer, and mm-hmm. so that definitely is very it takes a lot of support. Mm-hmm. And so for us not to even know, that means his family kept it close.
They
you know, they were there to support him however he needed to go through that. So, yeah.
That's good. What are your thoughts on that, Pastor?
It's kind of a catch-22 because mm-hmm. on one sense, you don't want to give the wrong people the wrong information.
Listen to me. Yes, sir.
One of the key issues is that some people will dredge your situation down. Mm-hmm. You have the negative Nancys and the doubting mm-hmm. Toms. Mm-hmm. So you don't want to give everybody your situation
That's
who don't
true.
Have enough faith to
That's
hold
right.
it up.
Delete
so
it.
Some mm-hmm. people will knock that thing down and make you feel worse. Oh, you know, my cousin just died from that or something like that. They don't have enough faith to believe the same thing that you believe. So it might have been right strategy for him to say, hey, you know what? I'm only going to share this with the kind of people who can handle what I'm going through, who can help me with my situation.
That's very true. And I think that's very true in this situation as well, because I'm going to play a clip of him. One of the best interviews that Charlie Murphy has ever done in his career, he was asked about his relationship with his brother, because everybody knows Eddie Murphy. Everybody knows Eddie Murphy. Mm-hmm. And it's very difficult to have a popular, famous brother. I actually experienced that myself with my oldest, one of my closest brothers. He's a very, very popular person. And so sometimes it's hard to live in their shadow. And he was asked recently, and his relationship with his family and his friends was so close. What you guys just mentioned were right on par. I want you guys to listen to him answering the questions about being famous under his brother's shadow and the alleged rumors of his brother being gay.
Well, I think what has a lot to do with that is that I'm not part of the crew, okay, the Eddie Murphy crew, mm-hmm. as far as comedians, you know what I'm saying? Like, the crew is like, you know, Chris Rock, Arsenio, that's his crew. I don't hang out with them. I go over and visit or whatever, but I don't hang out with them, and I don't hang around and try to get their energy or whatever, you know. As a matter of fact, I've not really gone around anybody like that, so I've been allowed to develop as me. I knew going in, like, you don't want to remind people of your brother. You don't want to, because if you remind them of your brother, trust me, they're not coming to see you again, because then now you're the fake Eddie Murphy.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You don't want to remind people of Bernie Mac. You don't want to remind people of Chris Rock. Mm-hmm. These guys already exist in people's minds. They validated. The only way you're going to win is if you remind them of somebody new.
Now, that was the late, great Charlie Murphy talking about him being a successful comedian, successful entrepreneur in his own right. He is being remembered by his brother, Eddie Murphy, and his adorable children that he had full custody of, because his wife had passed away a few years earlier than that. So, guys, that just happened in the news. We have so much in store for you guys today. So the second portion of that we will talk about in our second hour of the show. The second hour of the show, we're going to go live on YouTube, guys. So if you are listening, if you're watching on Facebook, come live on YouTube. You'll be able to see more of a behind-the-scenes, ask questions that you will not be able to ask, whether you're calling or whether you're chiming in. So definitely go to hashtag Moneymaker Motivation on YouTube. We're going to go YouTube live in the second hour of the show. When we get back, guys, we're going to talk about, I have an announcement that I want to make, a good business move for myself as well as the show. We have a new sponsor. I want to talk to you guys about that, and something you guys have been asking me a lot about. Also, we have more hot off the money presses, something that just recently happened today in the finance industry. We're going to talk about that right here on SSN ATL. This is Money Making Motivation, your number one source for economic empowerment, and I'm your host, E.DeanCole.
This message brought to you by Goodwill and the Ad Council.
Hey, Dean. How are you, Dean?
Hey, Dean.
Guys, you are listening to Money Making Motivation. This is your number one source for economic empowerment, and we are broadcasting live right here on SSN ATL. You can listen to us if you're in your GM vehicle. We are broadcasting live right now. We broadcast in front of 3.5 million individuals, 3.5 million people on all your GM vehicles. Hashtag Money Making Motivation, SensationStationNetwork.com. We are everywhere you want to be. You can tell a friend to tell a friend, and this is what we're going to be talking about, which is a carryover of last show, which was marriage and money. So I want to know what your two cents is on this. So I actually have in the studio Mr. and Mrs. Sunny, Pastor Mr. and Mrs. Sunny, that are They are the owners and the directors of the Marriage Club. Yes. So let me tell you guys about the Marriage Club. The Marriage Club is one of the best places you're able to go on Facebook right now to get good, healthy, balanced support, entertainment, education when it comes to marriage. There are over 375 married couples or engaged couples or used to be married or creeping around or just trying to see what they can do. Because listen, this book is all on there. Yes. And that is all at the Marriage Club, ladies and gentlemen. And we have them in studio with us. And you guys asked, we talked about marriage and money, and I wanted to bring to people that I love and respect and trust. And the reason why I love and respect and trust them is because the group is not a Christian group. It's a marriage group.
Yes.
And there are people from all walks of life, people who are agnostic, people who are Buddhist, Catholic, people who are atheists, people who are Muslim, but they all are about marriage. And that's why I wanted to bring them on, because you wouldn't even know that they were pastors unless they knew you guys or knew of you guys. And that's one of the things that I like so much, because ratchetness goes on because it's Facebook, it's entertaining, but most importantly, it's a good, healthy balance of good education, fun, and I wanted to bring them on. So, ladies and gentlemen, we have Mr. and Mrs. Sunny. So, round of applause if we could give it for them. That's good. So, how did you guys have been doing the Marriage Club for, what, about a year now, right?
Oh, well, she can tell that story better than I can. So, I like it, though. Thanks for coming to me. I'm gonna get out with her.
The Marriage Club, as far as what you see, that's been around for like 2 years.
2 years.
That's been around for 2 years. Now, we've had the Marriage Club for 7 years, actually.
Okay.
Started with a group of friends who was going to hold each other accountable. Mm-hmm. You know, all of our lives, people have been coming to us for advice and coaching and counseling. And so that's how it started, just a group of friends who were going to hold each other accountable. Mm-hmm. So from there, we orchestrated date nights around, you know, the city of Atlanta. Mm-hmm. And from there, just
exploded.
Yeah,
that's good. Local, internationally known and locally respected. Yes. That's awesome. So, what do you think about the camaraderie amongst the husbands with the group? What are your thoughts on that? About that,
I say man up. Mm-hmm. One of the biggest things that happens in our culture is that mm-hmm. we diminish marriage, and it's almost shunned. Mm-hmm. You know, you hanging out with your boys because you got boys, mm-hmm. right? Everybody kicking with their friends and stuff like that. And marriage is kind of frowned upon, you know, not mm-hmm. hollering at a woman, not being out there elusive, doing dumb stuff. Mm-hmm. They kind of look at that like, oh, you're a square, you're not really hip or something like that. But mm-hmm. I want to make marriage attractive. Kind of what we do is help people to understand that being married is not a taboo. Being married is not something unpopular. Mm-hmm. And we want you to understand that your struggle is not by yourself. There's somebody else going through mm-hmm. what you're going through. So we try to help them. That's what the Marriage Club is. It shows people that marriage is still popular. Excuse me, traditional marriage.
Yes.
I gotta say that, because there's a whole lot of there's a whole lot of support out there for the non-traditional marriage mm-hmm. sense, because it's new. It's mm-hmm. the new thing.
It's the pop thing.
And the government supporting mm-hmm. everybody's behind it, but we don't have enough people supporting the tradition of marriage, this thing which is the foundation upon which we build our whole country, kingdom, and everything around. Mm-hmm. It's diminishing. Mm-hmm. We're getting divorced at a 50% rate. So mm-hmm. almost every other marriage is getting divorced. So we got to do something to make people believe in marriage again. And this is a small piece of the puzzle, but we're trying to do our part.
That's good. I'm so glad that you guys are here. And ladies and gentlemen, they're going to keep it real. They're going to give it to you all the way straight. Realer than real deal, Holyfield. So we are taking your calls, 855-75-MONEY. We are also taking your comments. So if you message us on Facebook, hashtag Money Making Motivation, message us on Instagram, hashtag Money Making Motivation. The second hour, we're going to go live on YouTube. And YouTube Live is an awesome place because your information is asked live, but it is anonymous because it goes away. So I already know the questions we're going to get on the second half of the show. Yes. So guys, give us a call, 855-75-MONEY. Tweet us at E.DeanCole, hashtag Money Making Motivation. Instagram, hashtag Money Making Motivation. Send a courier pigeon, hashtag Money Making Motivation. We're going to send an intern to pull it down and answer your questions. Guys, this is your number one source for economic empowerment, and I am your host, E.DeanCole.
Sensation Station Network.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Money Making Motivation, your number one source for economic empowerment, and I'm your host, E.DeanCole. We broadcast live every Tuesday and Thursday from 1 to 3. We're broadcasting internationally on Sensation Station Network. We are also broadcasting live on satellite radio and all of your GM vehicles, guys, and this is a phenomenal show today. So if this has been shared to you, hit that share button, hit that like button, tell a friend to tell a friend. This is going to be one of the best shows that we've ever had. We're talking money and marriage. We have Mr. and Mrs. Sunny. in here, in the studio with us today. So I'm excited about that. How are you guys feeling about today's show?
Yeah, I'm excited.
That's good. That's good. So we're going to be taking your calls. We're going to be answering your questions, your tweets. Most importantly, guys, this segment, Spin It and Get It Right Back. Now, yesterday's show, we were talking about, you know, Janet Jackson allegedly is about to get $500 million in alimony for her third divorce. And so a lot of people were talking about how tradition, like you were talking about traditional marriage, that you would get together with someone to build. But now the way society seems is like, it's like, what can you get out of the person? But it's not always like that. But unfortunately, sometimes it is. What are your thoughts on that? What were your thoughts when you saw this? I thought it was fake news. I was like, you guys are lying to me. Like, I commented, stop giving out fake news. You make the media look bad. But it was real.
Well, you know, ultimately for me, I was a little saddened by it. Mm-hmm. First of all, three marriages. You know, God that's Almighty. Pretty sad that you have to go through three marriages. Mm-hmm. Now, I don't think we know all the, what's mm-hmm. behind that. I don't know, you know, speculation said abuse. Mm-hmm. Of course, if somebody's abusing you, you get out of that relationship.
You definitely do get out of that relationship.
But, you know, Janet hung in there for 5 years.
And
so,
three, and 2 months.
And 2 months, yes. So hey.
She hung in there for five years.
She had a strategy.
what were your thoughts when you heard about it?
$500,000.
$500 million.
I'm thinking, yes. What are the other two husbands having to pay?
That's true. Oh, I don't know how that works.
I mean, somebody got to put in on this tab.
That is too funny. So I would like to know your thoughts on that, guys. Hashtag money making motivation, how you can spend it to get it right back. Now, before we went into the break, guys, I said that I have some really good news and I want to share with you guys is that we have a new sponsor on board. Now, you guys have asked me, for you guys that have followed me on social media for quite some time, and you guys might not know who I am, my name is E.DeanCole. I am the CEO of E.DeanCole Financial. We are a consulting firm, and we specialize in working capital, alternative finance, and business credit development. And so I was asked to do the show because of a lot of the live videos that I was doing just teaching about financial literacy. If you go, it's just my passion. I feel like that when I die, I want Jehovah God to say, well done, my good and faithful servant, you made millionaires. Yes. And so that is what I feel like I'm called to do, to help people realize their goals. And in the journey of entrepreneurship, I spent a lot of time actually traded foreign currencies for quite some time. And a lot of you guys know that about me, and you have been asking me, Dean, are you going to teach a course? Are you going to teach a course? Now, we have DCFI, which stands for E.DeanCole Financial Institute, and we teach how you're able to build a business that's completely separate from your personal credit and build business credit and get funding and financing. We have over 250 clients enrolled in the online course. And in that course, we teach about real estate. We teach about business credit. We also are going to talk about funding for churches and nonprofits. But you guys have asked and asked and asked about doggone Forex and foreign exchange. Well, I'm so excited to say that the newest sponsor of Money Making Motivation, as well as the sponsor of Hot Off the Money Presses, forgive me, is Markets World Live, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, Markets World Live is a binary options trading platform where you're actually able to go and trade the option. I've been talking about options trading on the show for quite some time, and so I got on their radar, and so they are our newest sponsor, so they will be sponsoring that segment of the show, and because of that, I am going to be teaching a course online about the basics of binary options trading. Yes, so if you guys are currently enrolled into my course, you guys will be getting it free. Now, the release date, I do not know the exact release date. You guys know who I am, all of my clients. I work 24 hours. They're 7 days in a week, and there are 3 days I literally work 24 hours. I literally work 24 hours a couple of days. So that being said, I'm excited about that. That is being released. And so, ladies and gentlemen, I'm really excited about that. So today was a really good day for the U.S. dollar. The U.S. dollar performed pretty well because the unemployment rates came out. The unemployment rates came out in the green. It came out lower than expected. It was expected to come out at 25.78, and it came out at 25.0, and the U.S. dollar performed very, very well. Going into the Asian session tonight, guys, remember that it is a bank holiday. If you're going to be trading the Asian market, it is a bank holiday, so that means that the The Aussie dollar, the Japanese yen, is going to be a dormant stock to trade. Normally, it always stays dormant, but ladies and gentlemen, we're going to talk a little bit about that a lot more. So we're about to go into the break, and when we get back, we're going to be answering your questions about money and marriage. This is Money Making Motivation. So if you're watching on Facebook Live, hit the share button. We're going to go live on YouTube next hour, and that's going to be phenomenal because it is hilarious. YouTube Live, there's anonymous questions, and I cannot imagine what we're going to get. So this is Money Making Motivation, your number one source for economic empowerment. I'm your host, E.DeanCole, live in the studio with Mr. and Mrs. Sunny. Buckle your seats, come back, and get ready to learn right here on SSNATL.
It's a biggie beat.
Hey. Hey. No, I'm not going to freestyle today. Normally, I might bust out with a freestyle. I like that beat, that part. You can't fool with me like
marriage
that.
And money.
Marriage and money. Yes.
Hey.
Marriage and money.
Hey.
We're talking marriage and money, guys. This is Money Making Motivation, your number one source for economic empowerment. And I have the internationally known and locally respected Mr. and Mrs. Sunny in the building, the founders of Marriage Club. And you guys have a retreat coming up called Promise to Love Again.
Yes.
Listen, Janet Jackson just got the come up, allegedly, $500 million for her divorce. And Pastor Mauricio Sunny was talking about it earlier, how the marriage rate is at 50% on first-time marriages. On second-time marriages, it is at a little over 65%. And third-time marriages is at 75%. And myself, I am divorced. I'm believing God for a wife. Lord, where's she at? Father, please
I'm
let me find
her.
Listen.
Yes,
I need her. I'm trying to get out these streets.
Oh, let's go.
But hard-looking, hard times, I don't want none of those. But anyway. And so I am, and because of the statistics that you talk about, I am very guarded. I'm guarded. And I believe that my first marriage, even though she was a great person, just not great with me, and she's the mother of my daughter, I have a beautiful daughter, I said that that's my practice marriage, that I made the mistakes and I learned a lot about myself in that situation. Mm-hmm. And going into my new situation, wherever she might be, I want to make sure that this is married forever. Now, how long have you guys have been married? Have you guys ever been previously married before? What is your story?
No. We've been married for 21 years.
Come on, 21?
We are actually high school sweethearts. Ooh. So we've been together as long as I can remember.
That's awesome.
He taught me how to drive. So,
oh, wow.
Yeah. Yeah, that's 21
good.
Years.
21 years.
In love.
That's good.
Yes.
That's just a few
you
days.
Got, man, you got the man. Come on,
I did
man. I need to give me some of that look. 21 years? That's good. I'm talking about. Shoot. That's what I'm talking about. That's good. So, 21 years. I heard a comedian say yesterday, somebody asked him, he's been married for 30 years, and he said, the person, people asked, how do you stay married so long? He said, I just keep coming home. That's how that works.
Yeah, that will do it.
That will do it. But, so, what are your, like, if you guys don't mind, because you talk about promise to love again, has there ever been a time when you did not think you were going to make this 21 years?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
Man, let me tell you something.
Go ahead.
In my yearbook for mm-hmm. my high school, I initially stated that I'd only be married for 5 years.
Wow.
And I was getting divorced.
Oh, wow.
And sure enough, sometimes you got to be careful what you put into the atmosphere. Mm-hmm. I ain't trying to be all deep.
Mm-hmm.
But
it's
you really have to be careful of what you put in the atmosphere, because sure enough, at about that five-year marker, we were on the verge of divorce.
They call it the five-year itch. That's what people say. They call it the five-year itch. And I am very provocative, you know, so I'm going to give it to you straight. Money and sex are the two main reasons why most people get divorced. If it's not because enough money or not enough sex or the right type of sex. And so sometimes, and I don't mean to be offensive or anything, mean to offend you, but in coming into a situation in your dirty 30s is what they call it, you've experienced some things sexually. And so sometimes people say in that five-year itch, it's difficult when you have to just have one man to please you or one woman to please you. So coming up into 5 years, that's why people call it the five-year itch, but it's not for that reason. What was it like for you when you hit year number five? What was it? Who was saying I'm leaving? I know it was him saying he was leaving, and he was like, no, don't go.
No, I think we were all going to leave. Honestly, it really took moment, honestly, for us to stay together. I remember it was about Christmas, and I just said, let me get through Christmas, and I'm out.
Mm.
I'm out the door, and I think he might have loved me by then. Did you love me? I don't know.
I was starting to love her a little more.
I think he was starting to love me again,
mm-hmm.
but it really took a God encounter moment for me to say, oh, what, I'm letting all the things that we went through go, and we can start over again.
Oh, wow.
But my plan was definitely after Christmas, I was out. I call that my Christmas miracle, by the way.
Oh, wow, really?
Yeah.
So did you have any clue that she was going to leave after Christmas?
Yeah, I think we were kind of on the same page. We had reached such a dry season. Mm-hmm. Didn't know how to recover from it. I think part of the problem, we had gone through so many experiences and we didn't have a strategy to help us out of the situation or to help us kind of rekindle or redo the flames that we had before. So we were stuck in a rut. I mean, we had never experienced a relationship to kind of give us an example of a comeback story. So a lot of times, more than not, because we didn't have a right strategy, we didn't know how to fix it. I mean, it's one thing to be up against the ropes if you got a good strategy.
If you got a strategy, yeah, you know how to fix it.
You know how to get out of that situation. But if you don't have a strategy, you'll just continue to get beaten and beaten. But God came through for us. I tell you, man, that's he showed up and showed up.
So let me ask you this question. So, we know that God came through for you, which is great. That's good. What was the natural things that had to happen in order for you to make it past that? So besides the super, what was the natural? Because I believe in supernatural ability. I would not have what I have if it was not for supernatural. But I do believe in specificity and practicality. So what were some of the practical things that made you say, even though Christmas, I say I'm out, what was it that made you, who was it that you asked, you said that he loved you again. So was he the one that was pouring out the love that softened your heart, or was she the one that was pouring out the love that softened your heart? What was the natural, if you don't mind me asking? I'm just putting them on the spot live in front of 3.5
million. It's okay. I just got to a point where I just forgave. I think you have to just learn how to, if you're going to forgive, you have to forgive and let go, stuff go and move forward. You can't continue to hold things, and so that's what happened for me. I just kind of let it all go and said, we're going to start over from here. It's only a decision. Everything you do is just a decision.
That's
you make millions of thousand decisions a day, and all you have to do is make that one decision that we're going to stay together, we're going to work it out, and that's exactly what we did.
That's good stuff. So when she made that decision, how were things for you on your side of things?
Well, man, you know, for me, it was about learning to love again, because prior to that, we didn't have a real relationship. We weren't bonding.
For 5 years?
No, not for the whole 5 years, but we had come to a breaking point.
Okay.
You know, you go through so many things, and so much builds up, and if you never learn to release some of that stuff, it starts to just weigh you down to where we weren't even bonding. We were just in the same household.
Like roommates.
And it wasn't healthy. It wasn't a healthy relationship. But once we learned to detox some of that stuff, we saw different people.
That's good. We're going to talk about that, guys. When we get back, we're going to talk about what were some of the things that they saw, how they were able to get past the hump. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Text the person who you know is going through. Tell them to tune in to hashtag Moneymaking Motivation. We're going to go live on YouTube in the next hour. We're going to get raw and uncut. This is your number one source for economic empowerment, and we're talking money and marriage right here on Sensation Station Network.
They're strong, and there's Army Strong. See what it takes at GoArmy.com.
And so a new American industry has been born.
Sensation Station Network.
This is Money Making Motivation, your number one source for economic empowerment, and I'm your host, E.DeanCole. We are broadcasting live from Frisco to Maine all the way to Spain. We're going all the way around the world with this thing. You can listen to us at SensationStationNetwork.com, SSNATL2. We are doing live on all of your GM vehicles. If you are in your GM vehicle right now, if you're listening, you can listen to, if you are in there, that is, you're listening on satellite radio and the TuneIn app, and we have two phenomenal guests with us today. We have Mr. and Mrs. Sunny, and they were just talking about how they were at their breaking point 5 years into their marriage, and they end up deciding to make it work. And you guys have been together 21 years.
21 years.
21 years. Married.
Yes,
that's
married.
Good stuff. Yes. That's a blessing. You know, the number one best-selling book on marriage says that when a man finds a wife, he finds a good thing, and he obtains favor from the Lord. So that's a good thing, you know. And sometimes it's hard for us to keep the good things, and sometimes the good things don't want to be kept. Y'all ain't happy, but
he's saying something.
But nevertheless, it's a very good thing that you guys were able to go through that. And so before the break, we were talking about that, just the practical things. Now, if you guys don't mind me asking, you guys are very candid with your retreat. You have a retreat called Promise to Love Again.
Yes.
And where exactly is the retreat going to be this year?
This year we're back in Atlanta. Okay. If you know anything about the Cumberland area, yes, that is where we'll be this year. So many people asked us to bring it back home. Last year we were in Florida, so this year we're back home. So ATL, yes, you guys need to look us up, themarriageclub.org.
Yes, marriageclub.org. They will definitely be in the building. For more information, go to marriageclub.org. Now, what, if you don't mind me asking, what was it that you really had to forgive? What was it so much that made you want to leave? The reason why I ask that is because I was very transparent yesterday, well, on last show, and I am an old school type of guy. I am. I'm very domineering. I am an alpha male type of personality. And so I know that there are some things that make me attractive to women that they end up resenting in our relationship. Mm-hmm. And I was talking about how the same thing that allegedly Janet Jackson was saying, that he was controlling. Allegedly she was saying that he was controlling what she wore. And allegedly she was saying that he was he got even more controlling as a when she got pregnant with their son. Yes. And that being said, she knew that going in because, one, he was Muslim, mm-hmm, and number two, he was a billionaire. Mm-hmm. And so men who happen to have status and who have some business about themselves, you know, they carry that certain type of, that's how you, you have to develop that type of personality to be successful if you're going to build it yourself. If you inherited it, then that's a different story. But so that being said, I've had in the past where women love the fact that I work and that I'm an entrepreneur and that I'm multiple platforms, and then they hate the fact that I work, that I'm an entrepreneur, and I have so many different platforms. Like, women love the fact that I'm very much so old school, to where I would love to have a stay-at-home wife, and I would love to have that type of situation, but then they resent the fact that I would like to have a stay-at-home wife and that type of thing. So that being said, I think that the thing we were talking about yesterday was that the thing that attracted, I think, this is just alleged because we don't know, is that the thing that attracted her to him kind of start to wear off. And I wanted to know, you guys were high school sweethearts, so that means that you guys were developing in your womanhood and in your manhood as you guys were becoming more of a couple. So I know that that played a big strain on it as well. So when did you guys begin to really know each other and get so solid to where you can begin to teach? Because you guys are phenomenal coaches. Ladies and gentlemen, these are some of the best relational coaches. If you are wanting to be able to make it through and get to the next level of your marriage, then definitely reach into Mr. and Mrs. Sunny. I'm telling you, listen, when I tell you what I say, that you will be blessed, because they are so transparent, they're so real, and that's why I wanted to share my platform with them. So what was it, when did you guys begin to know each other and start to develop this love that we have enumerating in the studio right now?
So I don't know if I know when it happened. Mm-hmm. It just happened. I just remember us beginning to laugh.
Yeah.
And I just remember we just became friends. We literally became best friends. And I know people say that as a cliche, mm-hmm, but I enjoy being with my man, my husband. And so it just became a point where, like I said, forgiveness had taken place, laughter came back into the home, or the joy of the Lord, whatever y'all want to call it. Mm-hmm. And that it just changed for us. And, you know, I don't mean to sound all cliche-ish, but honestly, if it had not been for God, I don't know where we would be. And so it was honestly a God piece in our life.
That's good stuff.
Yeah. I give God the glory, but I also wanted to interject on the piece that you said about, mm-hmm, the balance, because, mm-hmm, I think what you were saying is balance. They want, yes, all of those things. They want somebody, mm-hmm, to go out there and get it. I'm a hustler, mm-hmm, by, yes, nature. Mm-hmm. I'm a renaissance man. My, mm-hmm, baby says he's brilliant, so I try to live up to that. I don't, yes, know that I'm there yet, mm-hmm, but I'm definitely trying to live up to that point. So one of the things that I have to do is make sure that I balance. How do I balance? By making sure no matter what I do, no matter what my priorities are, that she knows that she's a priority in, mm-hmm, my life. There's never going to be a question as to whether or not I'm going to spend time with her, because every Monday, mm-hmm, come rain, shine, hell or high water, mm-hmm, it's going to be with her. So, mm-hmm, I spend that time with her. I dedicate that time with her to make sure that she knows, in the midst of all these other things that we have going on, you are my priority.
That's good stuff.
I love you, so I'm dating you every Monday. And I tell even the church, I say, hey, if ain't nobody dying and nobody's dead,
Monday,
don't call me.
No, yes.
So you better handle it yourself, and I'll pray for you on Tuesday, because Monday I'm going to be with my girlfriend, my mistress, my, mm-hmm, wifey. I don't know if she's going to have red hair or blonde hair today. okay? But that's who I'm with today, so I'll holler at you on Tuesday.
That's good stuff. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Money Making Motivation, your number one source for economic empowerment. When we get back, I'm going to be reading your Instagram messages. So I'm about to go into Instagram. Send me a message, hashtag Money Making Motivation on Instagram. We're going to read your questions live on the air. Tell a friend to tell a friend. This is your number one source for economic empowerment right here on SSNATL.com.
Network.
Hot off the Money Princess, guys. What's going on in pop culture? What's going on in the news and how it affects you? Ladies and gentlemen, we had a very sad time, like we talked about on earlier in the show, is that Charlie Murphy, unfortunately, he had passed away. But he is not the only influential African-American person to pass away. We have some foul play is at foot. The first African-American judge, happens to be a Muslim woman, was found floating in the Hudson River early this morning, guys. Listen to this.
First African-American and Muslim woman to serve on New York's highest court has died. The body of Sheila Abdus Salam was found on the shore of the Hudson River near West 132nd Street. It happened this afternoon. There were no signs of obvious injury or foul play. Police are investigating. Abdus Salam had served as a justice on the State Court of Appeals since 2013. Governor Cuomo called her a trailblazing jurist and a pioneer.
That is amazing. I mean, guys, think about that. So foul play was at foot. She was found floating in the Hudson River. Did you guys hear about this?
Nah, that's my first hearing about it.
Yes. So she was found floating in the Hudson River. Now, a couple of things. Now, listen. Black Twitter, y'all going to go crazy. African-American, female, and a Muslim. Woo! Somebody got somebody. Yeah,
we got some answers
to say. But most importantly, this is the thing that I wanted to ask you, Pastor, or I can say First Lady, or Co-Pastor Sonny, is that Pastor Sonny talked about how on Monday, now I came up in the faith, so I understand. Mondays is normally the day that pastors are not talked about or touched or anything, because when he gets up and he speaks, really essence does leave. He's tired, he's vulnerable, and so those are the times that's available for you. Right. My question is, what is it like being not only a married woman, but being a first lady and a co-pastor, having to deal with such a vivacious, handsome joker over here? Ooh. What are some of the things that you have gone through
that
experience?
You know, honestly, I absolutely love being a first lady and a mm-hmm. wife. We do this together. We're a team. Everything That's we good. Do is a team. So, mm-hmm. you know, I don't have any pushback because, you know, he sets the tone. Mm-hmm. And so he sets a tone. People respect what he says. Mm-hmm. And he gives me the privilege to be his first lady. I think everybody knows it. And mm-hmm. I just kind of walk in that role. So we're a team. We're a team.
That's
no
good.
Pressure.
So you haven't had to have any of those Beyonce meme moments. Have you seen the Beyonce memes where it's Jay-Z and Beyonce on the front row mm-hmm. of the Knicks game, and she's looking sideways like this, and Beyonce, I mean, Jay-Z has his face, this look on his face, like, oh, not again. You haven't
no,
had
I'm good. Okay. Everybody knows I am the lady of the
okay,
house.
Okay, that's good.
So I'm all right with it. 21 years, I'm going to continue to be the lady of the house.
And the reason why is because you make such a big deal about letting everybody know, which is very important. And I tell you guys, listen, ladies, if you're dating a man right now, not if you're married or engaged, if you're married and engaged, I ain't talking to you. But if you're dating a man right now and he does not put you first, drop him, leave him where he stands.
Yes.
A man should never, ever hide who he's really in a committed relationship with, and vice versa. Fellas, if you're dating a chick right now and she's keeping you hidden as you the tune-up man, you deserve better than that. I need for you to go ahead and leave her where she stands and find somebody that is ready to be in that relationship with you. Now, I date quite a bit because I'm believing God for a mate. I'm really believing God, so the Bible says, when a man finds, so I'm searching, I'm looking. That being said, I've gone into dating relationships, and I've learned to be more discreet in my dating relationships, but I do go public once I know without a shadow of a doubt. And sometimes that's hard for women because they think that my inbox is jumping, which it does, but it's mostly jumping with financial questions, and today it's jumping with marriage questions, and we're going to be talking about your marriage questions, guys. We're going to be answering your questions live on Instagram, so hit me up at hashtag MoneyMakingMotivation on Instagram. We're going to answer your questions live, 855-75-MONEY. If you can get through the phone lines, we're going to answer your questions live on the air, and we are in our second hour. We're about to get ready to go live on YouTube, so get ready to tune in for that. So I said everything that I just said to say this, is that I think that it's very good that you said about, you know, putting her first, letting her know, and you being in that position. And a lot of times people don't really like to get advice from pastors and first ladies nowadays. Mm-hmm. If you look at the situation that just recently happened with Bishop Jake's spiritual son, and did you guys hear about that information? Did you hear about that? Oh, my goodness, I got to give you guys all type of bad news.
I know, I know.
So unfortunately, Bishop Jake's spiritual son was just found having an adulterous relationship with one of their spiritual daughters, who he happened to do the ceremony for the couple. So it's a married couple that was with another married couple. Now, I'm not going to lie to you to make it sound fly to you. I'm going to give it to you all the way straight. A lot of women have approached me that are married because they say, this is what they say now, is that if I'm going to creep, I'm going to creep with somebody that got something to lose. So that way I don't have to worry about anything. And I let them know I don't play those games. I don't do that. And vice versa. So I want to know what your thoughts are on that. We're being very real. I hope not to offend anybody, but we're about to start talking about the swinging lifestyle. We're about to start talking about marriage and all of that good stuff right here on Money Making Motivation, right here on SSN ATL, your number one source for economic empowerment. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Money Making Motivation, your number one source for economic empowerment, and we are about to get into it. Now, I just broke some news to Mr. and Mrs. Sunny that Pastors Hill, who are part of T.D. Jakes Ministries, who are Potter's House in Colorado, they are the pastors of Potter's House, Colorado, unfortunately, they got into a marriage scandal, and it was a little bit of, you know, foul play going on to where, you know, he was in a full-fledged adulterous relationship with another married woman who was married as well. So we talked about it a little bit before the break. So before we get into that, ladies and gentlemen, we're talking about shocking news. I just shocked them. And there was some shocking news that happened on yesterday, guys. So as you guys know, your president, Donald Trump, I call him Donald J. Bartholomew Trump. I don't know where the Bartholomew comes from. So he met with China, and during his entire campaign, he was ranting and raving about how he was going to say that he was going to tax China, tax China, tax China. But yesterday, he goes on to say, well, it's a little harder than we think. And one of the number one reporters who I admire and respect kind of lost it on live television last night. Listen to Anderson Cooper as he responds to Trump's flip-flop.
Trump said in the Wall Street Journal today that after listening to the Chinese president explain the history of China and North Korea for about 10 minutes, he, quote, realized it's not so easy. I mean, is that, I really am speechless. I don't know why I'm reacting like this.
But he said the same thing about health care.
Well, I know. Yes, of course. It's exactly what he said about health care, that nobody knew health care could be so complicated. But you know what? Actually, a lot of people did. In fact, pretty much everybody knew it was really, really complicated. I said to him in interviews, what do you mean take the oil? He would say, you're an idiot that you don't understand or that you do understand, but you're just pretending you don't. But you know what? You can't take the oil. And he now knows that. And he probably knew it then.
So that was some shocking news that Anderson Cooper responding to how Trump flip-flopped.
Dean, I got a question for you. Sir. Is it really shocking? I mean, we look at this. We got a president, and no disrespect. Mm-hmm. I always honor the commander-in-chief, but we're mm-hmm. looking at things from a non-political perspective mm-hmm. without truly having an insight mm-hmm. as to how the politics of a thing work. So you're not listening to the people who are trying to give you information. Mm-hmm. I mean, because every good king mm-hmm. had a good prophet or somebody in his corner
to mm-hmm.
who could give him the ability to help him understand how mm-hmm. to navigate through situations and things like that. You can't just go at it bullheadedly and just think that you're going to make things happen or going to. It's like it's not so easy. It's never been easy, but mm-hmm. yet you took this position without any insight, any background, or anything like that, and you're trying to look at it from just a numbers perspective. But mm-hmm. there's a whole lot of other variables that aren't being taken in consideration. Duh, mm-hmm. is my response to that.
That's, you know, that is very true. You talk about having that person. He did have Bannon as his number one guy that he was his business strategist, but Bannon is actually pulling away from him. He's pulling away from Bannon because of the conflicts of his son, and basically, you know, is getting involved, is dealing with the money. So mm-hmm. originally Trump ran on America, 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 but now when the reality sets in and the money is involved and his son is trying to deal this international trade, which Trump is known for, that's the reason why Bannon and now his son-in-law are having that conflict. conflict. So what you said is very true and very interesting when we talk about it. But I wanted to go into the shocking aspect of it because we just talked about this with the pastor. So what happened was that the first lady text the church. You know how they got this new cool thing where you can text everybody at the church?
Well, all right.
So okay. The first lady texts the whole church and said, y'all, I can't do it no more. I can't cover him up no more. I just called the cops on Pastor, and there are four cops at our house right now, and I threw his clothes into the jacuzzi, which was dry, because he is having an affair, and he mentioned the woman's name. And that's how everything exploded that came out on March 24th. So I said all of that to say this. What has it been like, you know, the good, the bad, and the ugly that you have seen in those type of situations? Because people like to talk about alternative lifestyle. You know, the number one best-selling book on marriage and development says that the marriage bed is undefiled. Some people kind of take that a bit too far. In my opinion, and I don't want to shame anyone. I don't want to freak shame anybody that's watching. I don't want to make any of my affiliates or even of my guests feel uncomfortable. But at the same time, because of the alternative lifestyle that is being perpetuated in the media, they are wanting to explore things sexually, and I want to know, what are your thoughts about that? Some people say not to open up Pandora's box, and I would like to know what your thoughts are about that, especially because you guys counsel so many couples and you have such a high success rate.
Go ahead, babe.
From an alternative lifestyle perspective, mm-hmm. I think that there's only, you're talking about bringing other folk into your relationship.
We're talking about threesomes.
Like yeah I believe in
that.
Threesomes. Mm-hmm. Me, my wife, and God. Come on.
That's
the only threesome that will keep us from having to go into witness protection or something like that.
Yes. And I feel the same way, too, because I, if I could be candid and transparent, I've been a believer all my life. You can't talk to me more than 5 minutes without something about my spirituality coming out, because that's my relationship with him. It's very, very real. I said all of that to say this. I have not experienced that before. And I don't know if I want to experience that because I am so territorial. I don't want somebody else sleeping with my woman, whether it is another woman. I was actually propositioned from a young lady I was dating, and she wanted to have a girlfriend. Y'all believe that? This is 2017. She wanted to have a girlfriend, and I was like, well, I said, well, would I participate? She was like, no, she'll be my girlfriend, and you'll be my husband. I said, what the world? Like, no, that's not
all
the
right.
Okay. But, you know, I was positioned with that. You know, that's very interesting. You know, these. That's why I'm trying to get out of these streets.
And it's funny, but it's sad. I mean, because we dealt with a couple.
I'm sad over here. I'm like speechless. I'm just like,
we
I'm having a moment.
We dealt with a couple. And, mm-hmm. and one of the guys that we were living underneath in our first apartment, and
that's
he
exactly
used to come downstairs and boast. You want to tell the story, babe?
No,
he
go
would
ahead.
Come downstairs and boast and brag and talk about
his two women
and how he had it made and how he just left the bed with his two wives mm-hmm. and whoop de whoop whoop. And one day he came downstairs crying.
I bet he did.
I said, what's wrong, man?
They kicked him out.
They left me.
Yeah.
For each other.
Who left you?
Mm-hmm.
My two women. I said, oh, wait a minute. I thought, you know, you had it. Now, I wasn't trying to be insensitive, mm-hmm. but he boasted about it so long.
Mm-hmm.
But he just didn't realize that this is just not, it's just not what God intended for his life.
Mm-hmm.
I truly believe that if that was his wife, why is he sharing her? If you really love somebody that much,
mm-hmm.
why would you share them with someone else? Why would you want to even have that experience? It's just not something that we agree with and we're into, and it
mm-hmm.
just doesn't. You know, it doesn't make sense.
And I've only seen it cause destruction. I've
mm-hmm.
never seen anything healthy come out of threesomes. Maybe for a moment they have that thrill, but in the
mm-hmm.
end, there's always somebody hurt,
yes.
someone always broken. And
mm-hmm.
so that's not God's ordained way for us to be. And so I just say no. My heart goes out to that family. I'm going to pray for that pastor and his wife,
mm-hmm.
you know, that God can even restore them wherever they are. But, man, just to feel that pain and that hurt, like I feel it right now. So, yeah, but only destruction comes from that. So
I agree.
Yeah.
When we get back, we're going to take more of your calls. I believe this is what I have to say on that. And this is the question that I ask myself before I pick the phone, before I make a call, I do anything, is that sin will always take you further than you want to go and keep you longer than you want to stay, and will always cost you more than you want to pay. That's just my 2 cents on the matter, guys. We're going to get more of your 2 cents right here on Money Making Motivation, your number one source for economic empowerment.
And the Ad Council.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Money Making Motivation, your number one source for economic empowerment. And we are live on Facebook, hashtag Money Making Motivation. And now we are live on YouTube. So if you guys go to YouTube, hashtag Money Making Motivation, we are taking your calls and your questions live on YouTube. YouTube Live is pretty cool because during the live chat, all of the questions are anonymous. So you can ask the questions that you want and not feel some type of way or not feel judged or embarrassed. Now, Before the break, guys, in the first hour of the show, I had some phenomenal news. I'm really excited about the latest sponsor of the show. We have a Markets World Live. It's the latest sponsor of the show, ladies and gentlemen. And Markets World Live has come on as our latest sponsor, and we are teaming up together, and we're putting together a free, capital F-R-E-E, course on binary options and trading. So I'm really excited about that, guys. So I am putting together the content for that, and they are doing the backings when it comes to that. I have so much to share with you guys on that. Markets World Live. This is live radio. Markets World Live is actually going to be doubling everyone's investments when you deposit, and we're going to talk about that a little bit later. They're going to be doubling up to $1,000. We're going to be talking about that a little bit later, but today I wanted to share with you guys the news and also talk about the latest that is going on in the Forex market. So today we had a very big day today, guys, in the U.S. dollar. The U.S. dollar market, anything that was going up against the U.S. dollar, whether it was Japanese yen or the GBP, which is the British pound, or even the euro, and also gold. Gold is U.S. dollar, performed extremely well today. It was very volatile today, so today would have been a very good day for you guys to make money on the update. It wasn't the NFP. The NFP did not come out, but I want to go over the numbers with you that the unemployment rate came out, and the unemployment rate came out at 98% higher than expected, which caused the U.S. dollar to skyrocket, ladies and gentlemen. So we were really excited about that. So we're going to be talking more about that here on the show, because Markets World Live is going to be our sponsors for how to spend it and get it right back. If you guys want to know how to invest in the real estate market, or invest in the foreign exchange, or invest even in relationships, this is your number one source for that. This is Money Making Motivation, and I am your host, E.DeanCole. And so we are talking relationships. So before the break, we were talking about, you know, alternative lifestyles and those type of things. And so I want to read some of these questions that we have. So let me go here to my messages, because I had them sent over to my messages. Bear with me for one moment here. All right, so let's see here. Let me get into the messages. So I would like to know, as I pull this up, what made you guys start going into the counseling? What was it that said, you know, we need to help others? Like, it's not just about us being successful, but other people being successful. What was it that made you guys want to do that?
Well, as you can see with that last question, it's a love and a burden that mm-hmm. God has placed on our heart. Honestly, mm-hmm. My heart for to see couples happy, healthy, and successful, mm-hmm. that's just a part of who I am. It's always been a call. Like I said, it started with a group of friends that always called on us. Mm-hmm. We didn't understand the call at first. Mm-hmm. And then after a while, we said, you know what, this is what we've been called to do. So this is a God-given burden and a love to see marriages that go to newer heights.
That's good stuff. And so what are your thoughts on that? What is some of the experience that you've experienced, Pastor Sonny?
Well, you know, sometimes you're just cut and made for a thing. We mm-hmm. realize at some point more and more people begin to gravitate to us. More mm-hmm. and more people begin to bring their issues to us, even without asking. You know, we weren't like going around soliciting, hey, can we help you with your marriage? Mm-hmm. Hey, can we fix this? But people began to bring us their situations, and God mm-hmm. began to give us clarity and help us to see, even through some of the experiences that we had, mm-hmm. that we have the innate ability to help other people. So then we post this thing up and start broadcasting it via mm-hmm. Facebook Live and mm-hmm. and different things like that, and then it grew like wildflowers.
Yeah,
to
you
the
have
point where
375,000
that's phenomenal people connected to our marriage group. And a lot of that has to start with my wife's vision of creating the marriage club and us wanting to cater and nurture relationships. This is genuinely what we are about. And one of the things that was even on my heart was thinking about that, Pastor. You know, one of the things that people have a sense of doing is when they hear the word pastor, they gringe.
Yeah, they
because
do.
Of the mm-hmm. hurts, the failures, and a lot mm-hmm. of the things that they've seen. Because first part of the issue is that we're lifting pastors up too high.
Yes.
We're just mm-hmm. people who hear from God mm-hmm. and convey what God has given to us. And we're people who often love more than others. So mm-hmm. we're more susceptible to issues, more susceptible to problems. So I don't want us to become so close-minded as to the point where we mm-hmm. think that all pastors carry the same level of foolishness. Because there's some of us out here who are trying to live right. But even when we fall, everybody falls sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Everybody does.
Everybody falls. Don't let Greenleaf and different shows get mm-hmm. you to thinking that all pastors are bad or that all ministries and churches are failing or out here to get you or to take your money or things like that, because mm-hmm. there's some true, loving, and genuine people out here who care about you and want nothing from you. Our inbox is flooded. Sometimes I have to go and answer some of the stuff in my wife's inbox because mm-hmm. she doesn't even have time to address all of the situations. There's people who come to us about suicide, mm-hmm. people who come to us about their relationships, people who come to us about problems and situations that they're facing, and we never ask them for anything in return because this is what we realize that this is what we've been born to do.
That's good stuff. That's good stuff. Ladies and gentlemen, this is one of my favorite couples, and so we are on live right now. We are live on YouTube, so we're going to ask your questions. I see all your questions that just came in, and I am going to start to go through and answer some of these questions, guys. Hit us up on hashtag MoneyMakingMotivation. Also, give us a call, 855-75-MONEY. That is 855-75-MONEY. This is your number one source for economic empowerment, and I love the fact that I have some people here that are very balanced. What are some of the things that you feel like has helped you to become balanced as a entrepreneur, even as a wife and a first lady? What are some of the things that you think has helped you to stay balanced? As I talk about balance, you can't see me if you're listening, but I'm having an issue with this little tripod. We're having all types of technical issues today. Phones dying, everything. But, hey, it's live and I direct, so go ahead.
Keeping me balanced. One, making sure my calendar is, I use a calendar. How about that? My husband, we function literally off of a calendar. That is mm-hmm. a way to keep me balanced. Other than that, you have so many things pulling at you. You can't stay organized to be able to be balanced. Mm-hmm. So for me, just using a calendar and using wisdom. You have to know when to give, when to pull back, when to move forward. You can't always be after so many things, because if you're after so many things, then something's going to get left behind. So for me, just making sure I know where I'm supposed to be, when I'm supposed to be, and to do what I'm supposed to do in a timely manner, if that makes sense. So,
okay, that's good stuff, guys. When we get back, we're going to answer your questions and we're going to take your calls. During the break, if you're on YouTube, I'm about to read your questions and go over your questions. This is Money Making Motivation. We have more with the phenomenal Mr. and Mrs. Sunny right here on Money Making Motivation, your number one source for economic empowerment. Guys, this is Money Making Motivation, your number one source for economic empowerment, and I'm your host, E.DeanCole. We are broadcasting live from Frisco to Maine all the way to Spain. We are broadcasting on Sensation Station Network. We're also broadcasting in all of your GM vehicles, and we are on YouTube Live, and we have some questions coming in. So I have a question from Ms. Kimmy Shark on Instagram. She says right here that I've been dating this gentleman for 5 years, and I want to marry him. How can I make him marry me? So I take it from your perspective as, you know, as the woman in this perspective. What are your thoughts
you,
on
brother.
This?
Thank you.
Yes,
saved
yes,
by
sir.
The bell.
Yes, sir. Yeah. I do understand.
So,
yes.
Kimmy, you know what? All you have to do is focus on you. You can't focus so much on the man. If he wants to marry you, that's going to have to be a decision, honestly, that he's going to have to make. But you be the best you that you have to be. You find yourself in this moment. You do the things that you love in this moment. Really, you worry about Kimmy. You be the jewel. You make him see the jewel that you are. But don't be so focused on trying to make him marry you. Because if you're chasing a man, you'll always be chasing a man. So allow him to chase you. And you be you. And trust me, be that beautiful diamond that you are. And if he doesn't see it, I'm sure somebody else will.
Okay, that's good stuff. That's good. What are your thoughts on that? I'm going to give you my 2 cents on the matter.
But man, let me just say this. Part of the problem is that what we readily have, we don't always want.
Say that one more time.
What we readily have, we don't always want. And, mm-hmm. and sometimes we don't see the greatness because it's too close up on us. Because oftentimes, more than not, we don't value what we have when it's right there. Mm-hmm. But when we don't have it as much, we got to obtain it. We got to figure out what it is. So more than most of the time, a lot of times, if you're trying to get to a point of marriage, you can't be in a married relationship without the marriage. What am I saying about that? You can't give him everything that a wife would give him if you're just a girlfriend. I'm not
true.
Trying to go too deep or too spiritual on you, but think about it for a minute. Why should he marry you if he's already got all of the wife qualities? If you're cooking for him, washing his clothes, doing everything he needs you to do to show yourself as wife
you
quality.
Know something, Doc, I want to chime in on the other side of that. Let me tell you my thoughts on that. These are my thoughts on that. Now, I don't condone or promote or whatever people do sexually. At the same time, I think that when, as a single man, if I am commanded to give my life like Christ gave the church, if I'm supposed to love my wife like Christ loved the church, and I got to give my life to her, I want to make sure that she is worth being given. She can handle it. Also, another thing is that I think that a lot of people want to be married, and a lot of people want to have sex, and a lot of people want to be booed up, but a lot of people don't want to be husbands, and a lot of people.
We got to keep God first. We got to stay humble. We got to keep working, and we got to get this money. Economic empowerment. Is what's going to keep all of us on the street now.
Yeah.
Everybody.
Like Jesus.